Today's readings will be taken from Morgan Harper Nichols' new book, You Are Only Just Beginning. This reading is from the selection titled Lessons from Guitars. A guitar is just some hollowed out wood, a few strings, and some pegs. Individually, no single component seems particularly special, but with some craftsmanship and skill, all these parts come into alignment to create what I believe to be one of the most beautiful objects mankind has ever made. When I hold a guitar, I feel like I come alive. With a simple stroke of the hand, I can strike a chord and music fills the room. People inevitably turn their heads. They can't help it. Music is powerful. Music isn't something we can see or touch or smell, but we are so affected by it. How can we be so swayed by something we cannot observe? I often think the same thing about our emotions. We are not always able to see or fully understand where our emotions are coming from, but they play such a commanding role in our lives. Sometimes they're out of tune and we find it jarring. We find ourselves begging our minds to please turn down the music. It's too much, too loud. Other times we're longing to hear a song again within us, but the song doesn't come. Sometimes, however, when we find that perfect song inside and express true emotions, it feels like we're at a concert made just for us. We find ourselves more vulnerable and open to others, no matter how well or poorly we play those chords. It's evident when we're in tune with ourselves. We have learned how to strike those chords all on our own. At every state of the journey ahead, emotions will rise and fall, and we owe it to ourselves to let them pass through us as we learn to enjoy this ever-changing song.
Don't speak.
Don't touch.
Don't breathe.
Don't move.
There will be no singing anymore.
It is out of our control.
No one is listening.
Don't speak. Don't touch. Don't breathe. Don't move.
No singing.
The world is silent.
Still, without voice, we sing.
It's not the change. As the tenor bass choir is walking to their seats, I am so excited to welcome up the Heritage Gospel Choir, which is a new choir this semester in our choral program. Let's give them a round of applause as it
Choir, and we're so excited to be here. This is our debut performance here in the School of Music, and so we are very excited to be here. And so we're going to ask you to probably sing with us. This is gospel, and this is what we do, so it's going to be a lot of fun.
The sounds of joy and sorrow reverberate in the air around us. Two songs always playing. We will be swooned by the delight of new beginnings, but find ourselves weeping when we realize that means we have to let go in order to grow. But the more we live, the more we will find that it's about finding how we make those songs pair well together. We learn to sing with gracious strength, singing of our pain and all the good that we've gained, by embracing the full tone and the range of notes that life has brought us.
Oh, how he loves us. bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me.
By the grace in his eyes, if grace is an ocean, we are all sinking. So heaven meets earth like an unforeseen kiss, and my heart turns violently inside of my chest. I don't have time to maintain these regrets when I think about the way he loves. And he is our prize, drawn to redemption by the grace in his eyes. And if grace is an ocean, we are all sinking, sinking, sinking. So heaven meets earth like an unforeseen kiss, and my heart turns violently inside of my chest. I don't have time to maintain these regrets when I think about the way he loves. Yes. How he loves. How he loves us. He loves us. Oh, how. Take it up. He loves.
Loves me.
Come on, make it personal.
He loves me. Oh, how he loves me. Oh, how he loves me. Oh, how he loves us. He loves us. Oh,
to my heart, Holy Spirit,
give me the words.
Love,
to encourage me.
this. Listen to this.
Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, yeah. Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, yeah.
Do it.
Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, yeah. Talk to me.
Come on, do it with us.
Talk to me, yeah.
Talk to me, say.
Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, yeah. Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me.
Speak to my heart, Lord. Give me your holy word. If I can't hear from you, then I know what to do. I won't go alone. I'll never go on my own. Just let your spirit guide. And let your word abide. Speak to my heart.
Like music, your emotions are meant to be expressed and explored. Follow what is unpredictable. You might feel tempted to hold back when you're not sure if the chords you play will come out the right way, but it matters, so try to play anyway. You might be afraid of how others will respond when you play out of tune or when your melancholy strikes a chord much harder than you meant for it to. But the truth is, even if others don't like the music of who you are, you must let it echo anyway, for it is real. It is yours.
This next piece is called Skin. It's by Mari Esbel Valverde. It is I'm pretty sure it's the Midwest premiere. For sure the Wisconsin premiere. This is a consortium premiere. What that means is Mari wrote this piece, finished this piece right before COVID-19 shut everything down. And so the way the group I think she was originally writing for, that kind of went off the rails. And so then she reached out to some directors that she knew, and she said, hey, any interest in coming together for this consortium? And a consortium is when a bunch of different choirs contribute smaller amounts of money to make it a little more affordable for this piece. I'm pretty sure the only group I know of that has sung it was in Ithaca, New York. So here we are, Skin.
Thank you. This next piece has some audience participation. And in the text that came with the program, under the piece mantra, there are some words about halfway through that are in italics. You are going to hear tribal choir sing the words, drink plenty of water, and repeat after me. And then they're going to share a line or a mantra, and then you will repeat it. You will know, partly because you're following along maybe in the lyrics, partly because they'll say, repeat after me, and you'll say, yes. And because I will turn around and be like, it doesn't have to be perfectly sung. We just want you to use your voice.
Let us travel away from the city and go, where green fields grow untouched and free, where the wind is music and the horizon line is a guitar's string. Let us hum the tune of gratitude as we cross paths with those we meet, and let us walk together, our feet becoming instruments, a song of togetherness, compassion so loud it cannot possibly be ignored. It is good when we sing in harmony. Our difference is a felt reality, as real as the ground beneath our feet. Together, a song much richer, sweeter, and stronger than any melody I could write on my own. May there be peace between us and peace beyond understanding. May there be places in nature where souls feel free to roam and simply be. Take me there.
Thank you.
how we reflect who they are and not who I am.
It's okay to be a work in progress.
Sharing your feelings doesn't make you weak.
Some days are still such a struggle.
All I can think about is Ellen. I wish you kept living.
I decided to ask for help instead of going through it alone.
It was hard as hell, but I kept living.
One person took the time to listen and understand. Sometimes that's all it takes.
I would like to invite up Tim Arnold. He is the Assistant Director of the UWO Counseling Center. Tim came up. Tim. When we were first planning this concert, I reached out to Tim and said, hey, we're doing some things that we're really focusing on mental health and mental health awareness. Do you think you can come speak to the choirs? And so he did, and I'm going to turn it over to you.
Well, thank you, Dr. Gravelle. Thank you, UWO Choirs. Fantastic job. And thank you so much for continuing to spread the important message of mental health and wellness. Honored to be here today. Again, you gave me the lyrics ahead of time, but wow. I think, unfortunately, mental health and wellness is becoming more and more normalized, but I think unfortunately it's because it has to. The pandemic has been really, really difficult on everyone. And what I really loved about this last song was, I think some of the ways that we can promote wellness for everyone is through connection, harmony, if you will, but also being vulnerable. And we live in this kind of Midwest culture where I think it's really scary to admit, hey, today is a tough day. Out of curiosity, with a show of hands, how many of you here tonight have been directly impacted by either your own or someone else's mental health challenges? Look at all the hands around you. And I think, right, the humanness of us, there can be some shame or some guilt. We don't want to be a burden. And yet, the majority of us here tonight raised our hands. And so I'm asking all of you here today to be vulnerable. But more importantly, can we make a pledge to let someone else know in our lives that we see their greatness? Maybe it's a simple smile or a hello. Maybe it's inviting someone to lunch. Because there's so many people that keep silent, keep our heads up, pretend everything is okay. And yet there's so many that are suffering beneath the surface. I think it's really fitting that today starts Titans Cares Week, which is an initiative for suicide prevention on UWO. It's something that we are going to continue moving forward about halfway through the semester. Students, faculty, staff, you will see the Counseling Center and other campus partners handing out freebies and just being present. But more importantly, we want to be present for you. We may not have the answers, but again, it can be really powerful to have that listening ear. If any of you know someone who is struggling, or you're wondering, maybe, hey, I'm wondering if everything is okay, reach out. After the concert, I will be at a little table up there, and we have some handouts. Students, there are a lot of resources for you. There will be a little connect card with a QR code, and if you scan that and enter in the information either for yourself or a friend, one of the counselors at the Counseling Center will reach out to that person. Non-students or students that maybe don't want to come see me at the Counseling Center, and that's okay, there are other options as well. I have a handout where it kind of goes through how can you get connected to mental health services and support. Whether it's through county services, whether that's through a primary care physician, it gives kind of a bullet point of non-emergency and emergency services. Again, I'll be up there for anyone that has questions afterwards. And again, thank you so much for the opportunity to speak tonight. Wonderful job, choirs, and thank you for all you do.
Oh,
I had it planned to speak at this spot, but now I feel like I want to explain a little bit of this concert. So I started thinking about this theme really, truly after COVID-19 shut things down. And when we kind of all came back together in community at my former institution and then again here, I just noticed that sometimes students were not just having a hard day. And it's really important to me, especially when you care for your students, to support them and validate them. And so this is where this came from. This is where this concert came from. So we've had a lot of discussions about the text. And I hope that you this evening have been able to read through the text or listen to it and take something from it. Whatever you need, take what you need, right? Yeah, and so this final piece on the chamber choir set is called My Heart Be Brave. Dr. Marcus Garrett wrote it. I think it was premiered by Seraphic Fire. But the text is by James Weldon Johnson, who notably, I want to say, wrote Lift Every Voice and Sing. So there's a lot of history behind this piece, behind the text specifically.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going to invite the other choirs up, the treble choir and the tenor bass choir, and well, I have a piece of paper with thank yous, but I no longer have it in my possession, so we're just going to wing it, and this is going to be great. I'm not going to forget anybody. Okay. First, I want to say a huge thank you, and can we just give another round of gratitude for the gospel choir who premiered tonight? It's a joy to be able to collaborate with Dr. Simpson. What a great colleague. Thank you. I want to say, there's on the back page of your program, there are thank yous. Please peruse them. I'm going to say thank you to Deb McKenzie. Thank you so much for playing tonight, being with us. Thank you to Tim for coming in, and well as your colleague Tyler. Thank you so much. Thank you to all my colleagues that are here. I have really amazing colleagues. I feel like I say that at every concert, but it's true. And a big heart of thank yous for the students behind me for engaging with this music in real authentic ways. And we talked about how with this music, we're just on a journey, and maybe we'll come up to that emotional line and we'll have to, that's where we won't go any further. Maybe we'll jump over it, who knows? This concert is also a journey. Thank you for being here and experiencing this with us. And it is my sincere hope that you are able to take something with you tonight. Our final piece, Ngotando, is a hymn out of South Africa in isiZulu language. And I really encourage you to read the text. We've sung about a lot of heavy things tonight, but as Tim said, in community, and when we share with others and through love, we can make it through hard situations and joyful ones. Thank you for being here tonight.
Let today be the day you allow your joy to be loud and unapologetic. There are birds in the backyard singing of springtime sun showers. The tree's branches, nature's drum kit, plays their new leaves. Rain crashes like cymbals into puddles below. Music all around us, each and every day. And I know there is music in you too. Here's to embracing life's song. One small moment of joy at a time. Let us unapologetically enjoy the sounds of this ongoing symphony.